फॉर नीट प्रिपरेशन सब्सक्राइब प्रोफेसर श्रीवास्तव बायोलॉजी लेक्चर्स सो दैट यू कैन गेट रेगुलर अपडेट्स.
इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैड डिस्कस अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ यूनिट डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म. देन वी हैड डिस्कस अबाउट आई थिंक प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर डिस्कशन विद डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ लिविंग वर्ल्ड. Diversity of living world. Now, basically, when you talk about diversity of living world, the each organism, what we see dogs around, we see cats around, whatever the organism we see, that will represent a species. And if you calculate the number of species that we know, the number will goes about 1.7 to 1.8 millions of the organism, or you can say that species we know. Now this number of the species we know, that will refers biodiversity. Now basically when you talk about this term that is called as biodiversity, in simple language I can say that the biodiversity is considered to be a types of organism that are present on this universe. And that will refer biodiversity. The one point you should keep in your mind, the number of species that we know, that is about 1.7 to 1.8 millions. Now basically when you talk about the organism, am I right? So when we start studying the diversity of organism, the one point you should know that each organism has given a name. The method of naming the organism is called as nomenclature. Now basically when you talk about the nomenclature, previously we use common names, but the cases happens that the common names, whatever is present, that is called as vernacular names. These common names will keep on changing from place to place. So when I talk about the common names are keep on changing, so that will create lots of confusion into the organism's name. That's why there will be need to standardize the nomenclature so that the organism, whatever is present, this organism will recognize by only one name throughout the universe. And giving the one name to the organism, that system, whatever is present, that is nothing but called as scientific nomenclature. This method is called as which nomenclature? Scientific nomenclature. So scientific nomenclature is something that all the organisms has given a one specific name which is common to the whole universe. Now basically when you talk about the nomenclature, when you deals with the nomenclature of organism, it becomes essential that the organism should be described correctly. Now when you supposed to consider that organism should be described correctly, describing the organism correctly, that particular method when you talk about, that is nothing but called as identification. What is it called? Identification. So you can say that giving a proper name to the organism, that is called nomenclature. Now describing the organism correctly, that is called as identification. Now basically when you talk about this particular you can say that nomenclature and identification, more specifically for a nomenclature, the scientists have standardized the system of nomenclature. They had assigned certain rules, certain principles to the nomenclature, and all these rules and principle came under International Code of Biological Nomenclature. Now, International Code of Biological Nomenclature, when you talk about, this is applied for both. This is applied for plants and this is also applied for animals. Now, later on what will happen, the International Code of Biological Nomenclature will give rise to two disciplines or two branches. The first branch, whatever is present, that is called as ICBN, that is International Code of Botanical Nomenclature. International Code of Botanical Nomenclature. And this International Code of Botanical Nomenclature gives the principles related with plants. The second branch which arises from this, that particular branch is considered to be ICZN. Now when you talk about the ICZN, the Z stands for Zoological Nomenclature. So it goes to International Code of zoological nomenclature. And international code of zoological nomenclature is for animals. So you can say that the branch of nomenclature which deals with principles and criteria for the plant nomenclature is called as ICBN, that is called International Code of Botanical Nomenclature. And the branch of biology which deals with, you can say that animal nomenclature, that is considered to be ICZN, which is called International Code of Zoological Nomenclature. Now one point you should remember, ki if someone asks you International Code of Biological Nomenclature, that is applied for both plants and animals. But if it goes to the botanical nomenclature, that is applied for the plants. And if it goes for the zoological nomenclature, that is applied for the animals. Now all this nomenclature system when you talk about, this nomenclature system is more standardized by one nomenclature system that is called binomial nomenclature. And this binomial nomenclature, whatever is present, this binomial nomenclature is proposed by the scientist, that is Carlos Linnaeus. And all of you know that Carlos Linnaeus is father of taxonomy, am I right? So when you basically talk about the nomenclature is based or nomenclature is more clarified by Carlos Linnaeus by giving a binomial nomenclature. Now basically when you talk about the binomial nomenclature, this binomial nomenclature has certain laws or certain principles. The first point you should remember, ki binomial nomenclature, the each organism has given a name and that particular name consists of two words. Listen carefully. The binomial nomenclature when you talk about, in binomial nomenclature, the each organism has given a name which consists of two words. Now basically when you talk about these two words, let us talk, this is first word and this is second word. The first word will represent that organism ka genus. And the second word, whatever is present, that will represent species. Now another point you have to remember, that when you talk about the genus, this genus in English language, it is considered to be noun. But species, when you are supposed to consider, the species is considered to be adjective. So basically when you talk about the human ka name, I think it is Homo sapien, am I right? So Homo means man, so that represents noun. But sapien means more intelligent, that is bring about adjective. And that's why when you talk about the first word which is representing genus, that is we call generic name. That is called as which name? Yes, generic name. But when you talk about the species, it is adjective. And that's why this is called specific epithet. What is it called? Specific epithet. So you should remember, ki someone asks you, ki why generic name and specific epithet, you should say that, Mr. generic name is noun and specific epithet is considered to be an adjective. Now another point you have to remember regarding with binomial nomenclature is that the first word, whatever is present, that is, you know, it is generic name, am I right? And the second word, whatever is present, that is specific epithet, am I right? Now when you talk about the generic name, one point you should remember, the generic name ka first letter, the first letter of the generic name, whatever is present, that should be written in capital. And the specific epithet, whatever is present, its first letter, whatever is present, that first letter should be small or should small, start with small letter. Okay, second one. Whenever you talk about these particular binomial nomenclature, whenever these binomial nomenclature are handwritten, whenever it is handwritten, it should be separately underlined. It should be separately underlined. That does mean that you have to underline generic name separately and you have to underline specific name separately. Third point you have to remember, that whenever the binomial nomenclature is printed, this particular binomial name should be printed in a font and that font is considered to be italic. This is because all the binomial names when you are supposed to consider, they are taken from a language that is Latin. So all the binomial names are having Latin origin. And to indicate their Latin origin, they should be printed in a font that is italics. And the last rule you have to remember, that whenever the author name you have to mention, whoever given a name that particular plant, so author name, whatever is present, that should come after specific name. So you can say that ki, if I suppose to consider ki this is specific name, am I right? So here you should mention author name, and this particular author name should be in a short form that is considered to be abbreviated form. It should be in abbreviated form. So let us rapidly revise what are the rules of binomial nomenclature. So binomial nomenclature is proposed by Carlos Linnaeus. The organism has given a name which is consist of two words. Am I right? The first word, whatever is present, that first word indicate genus, and species, second word, whatever is present, that will represent species. So genus, noun, generic name, species, adjective, specific epithet. The generic name ka first letter should start with capital, and specific name ka, specific epithet ka first letter should be small. Whenever they are handwritten, they should be separately underlined. Whenever printed, they should be printed in italics to indicate their Latin origin. And author name should appear after specific name in abbreviated form. This is considered to be rules of binomial nomenclature.